You know, the relationship between Richard and Dolores, I mean, think about it. Richard and Dolores are really, truly a power couple. Dolores was there as a co-founder of the union, and Richard was there, you know, supporting his brother on every level possible.
To watch them together, it is so great to know that this powerful team who has so much energy.
You know, she is a dynamite woman. I mean, she's a firecracker. And what makes it work is that he supports her 1,000%, because you know what, he believes that she's still out there fighting, you know, for the rights of others that don't have any.
The first time I met Dolores, my first impression was, how could this sweet, little, fragile, petite woman be the same person who has created and advocated so much change in the world? Her presence is so powerful, but yet her spirit is peaceful.
Dolores, because of her reputation, whenever she walks into any room, you're already floored by the presence of someone who has such a lengthy history of sacrifice and leadership.
What I love about this woman is that she's always on the front lines of every single issue, and she's determined.
Dolores is somebody that I think will go down in history, in our literature, as someone who came from humble beginnings and gave so much of herself.
She's a true icon, and I always said if there was five people at the table that I'd really want to sit down with, it would be Dolores Huerta.
She did politics, she did labor organizing, and she had 11 kids. Hallelujah.
It's a stunning drive that she has. In the face of physical adversity, in the face of insurmountable political odds, she doesn't need to sleep like other people. She can fly all night across the country to lend a hand to a cause that's important to her. And her causes are beyond just simply the cause of farm workers.
She's become a real feminist. She's understood we're going to fight for the rights of farm workers and for the rights of women. So she's been a great voice for women in this country and around the world.
Dolores's greatest accomplishment is that she becomes an outspoken advocate for so many different groups of people, and really epitomizes the notion that it's all one struggle.
You know, courage and conviction just is the stuff her blood is made of. She uses whatever adversity comes her way or she encounters and transforms it into the benefit of others and her cause.
In 1968, my father talked about how she made such a difference to his campaign. Later on, she formed the Robert F. Kennedy Health Fund for the farm workers. And I've been touched, as has been my whole family, by the fact that she would name that fund after my father. He believed in healthcare. He believed very strongly in community organizing. He believed in what Dolores Huerta did and would be so thrilled to see how much she's accomplished.
I can remember the fact that growing up in Yuma, that Richard, because our family stayed behind in Yuma, and Richard, with Cesar and everyone else, had moved on. We always followed the family, but we really started to become more involved with Richard later in life. But my father would always speak about Richard and Caesar, especially Richard.
This is a man that is just amazing, who has life, who has a great spirit.
I'm in awe. When I'm sitting with Richard, I would get the real story as to really, truly what is not just our background story as a family, but really how and why the union began.
You know, when I think of that big bird, and I call it the big bird because it's the eagle, when I think what Richard has done and the foundation that he has laid and what he has contributed.
Here's the greatest logo of all, and it comes from Richard. Now, Richard is a designer. He's an artist. So he was the artist of the family. And so Caesar said, give me something simple, and it should be the eagle, a strong symbol that shows patriotism. But also, it also shows, you know, a symbol of Mexico, a symbol of the U.S. So there's the forming of really one of the most symbolic symbols of all time.
When you listen to him and the pride he has, and still today, when that man speaks, you listen. And not only that, when you speak, that man is right there.
He's a carpenter. He left the fields to become a carpenter. Who built Delano? Richard did. You know, Richard built the buildings that are there and built the building that Caesar fasted in. He supported Caesar on every level as a carpenter, but the hardest, I think, thing he ever did build was when he crafted and he built Caesar's coffin and he had died. You know, can you imagine? I mean, can you seriously imagine, you know, how can one build the coffin? The simple pine coffin, you know, that he built. That is a labor of love, you know, I guess when you can say goodbye to your brother and your best friend, you know, so I think of Richard as the builder, you know, and that must have been the hardest thing he built.
Dolores Huerta is the very embodiment of personal power, of empowering the individual to make change. She did it then, she's doing it now, and I bet you she'll outlive us all and do it tomorrow. She's got a fuerza, man.
Again, it goes back to the foundation. He is a builder, one brick at a time, one day at a time, one step at a time. And when you have that kind of work ethic like that, you can't lose.
I think Dolores Huerta will be remembered as a real icon of the civil rights movement.
I want every young woman and man in this country to know what she's done, and really everybody around the world. This is a person with the mother of 11 children who has changed history.
Every generation there's a storyteller, and that's who Richard really is and who he's become. And what Richard wants to do is to make sure we don't forget who we are. You know, because if we forget who we are, then we have no idea where we're going.